There is a house in New Orleans that they call the Rising Sun, and it's been ruined many a poor boy, and God, I know. You know he stole my new blue jeans. My father was a gambling man down in New Orleans. Is a suitcase and a trunk, and the only time he's satisfied is when he's on a drunk. To New Orleans to wear that ball and chain. Children, not to do as I have done. Spend your life in fear, misery, in the house of the rising sun. In New Orleans that they call the Rising Sun, and it's been many a poor and God. Well, I know I'm
okay, we're in conversation with Jinder. Thanks for taking the time to have a chat to us. Pleasure. When did you first start singing and songwriting?
I've been singing since I can remember, ever since I was a little kid. My grandmother used to sit me next to her on a piano stool, and she'd play sort of old standards and one thing or another, Hoagy Carmichael songs and things like that. Nightingale sang in Berkeley Square and all of that. And I used to sing along with her when I must have been 3 years old, 3, 4, something like that. Right. And I've been singing ever since. I started playing guitar when I was 11. I played piano for a bit before that. But I picked up the guitar mainly to write. I always wanted to be I still do want to be a songwriter one day when I grow up.
What sort of music and performers have influenced you most, would you say?
It's hard to say. I mean, I grew up listening to a lot of kind of country, Americana type stuff, blues and so on. And I come from a very kind of roots music background. Until recently, I've always kind of suppressed the blues influence a little bit. It's always been there, but I've always kind of held back a little bit with that because I think, you know, everyone's out playing blues, aren't they? But you gradually, you know, I think as I've got older as a writer and a performer, you start to embrace who you are and just say that I'm going to play some blues, I'm going to play some country, I'm going to play some rock and roll, I'm going to play folk, whatever, you know. And I suppose the people who have influenced me the most, the first person that springs to mind is Townes Van Zandt, who was a huge influence, still is a big influence on me as a performer. He had a great work ethic, didn't have a year, spent his life on the road, and was an incredible artist. Too numerous to mention. I grew up listening to a lot of people like Emmylou Harris and Johnny Cash and so on. So a lot of people like that, musically speaking. And also, I love soul music. I love Marvin Gaye. I think he's probably the best singer I've ever heard in my life. Just incredible. His voice just melts me. And I love also some music that was kind of around when I was a kid a lot. I love bands like Steely Dan and Crosby, Stills and Nash, the whole kind of 70s. Movement, you know, that's just great stuff. So there was some really like gilt-edged high quality music coming out in the 70s that I think a lot of artists have struggled to match since then.
Asking for a dollar to buy myself some booze. This city ain't so pretty when out here on your own. So I ain't chasing rainbows anymore. I'm going home. Dreams all blew away, just like trees smoke. I can hear a train in your voice when you're speaking. I can hear goodbye in the wind in your throat. I can feel the ears everywhere as you open. Kinda makes me wish I never spoke. You know, it seems so long ago. I was raised a dreamer, and I knew which way to go. Life was never easy, and I watched my parents cry. When the crops failed, and I knew we'd have to move away. I can hear those feels in your voice as you're speaking. as you're breathing. Kind of makes me wish I never spoke. The dance of music carry across the plain through my bedroom window. And I was just 13. I miss those southern summers, and I miss loving you in the spring. Most of all, I just miss everything.
Success, haven't you? It's only recent.
I've been lucky, I think. I mean, I've been able to earn a living from music. I mean, I'm 29 years old now. I've been able to earn a living from music since I was 18. In the last few years, things have kind of gone through the roof for me. I get asked to write a lot for other people. You know, I have a great publisher who's constantly putting my songs into other artists. You know, I've written for, you know, I've got records coming out, songs coming out this year on records that are coming out through Sony, to Universal, various acts. I'm not going to be vulgar and drop names, but but it's like, you know, there's so much, you know, there's so much opportunity out there for writers that I think an awful lot of people don't ever get to explore. And I think a lot of your luck, music industry wise, is of your own making. I think it's about going out and making the contacts. I mean, I've been releasing records for 8 or 9 years. It's just been through being pushy and just hustling, you know, meeting up with people, being on the phone all the time to people like managers and booking agents, publishers, record companies, you know, A&R men, that kind of thing. But I have had a lot of luck to some extent.
You play some big venues. I mean, obviously, the live footage we've got is Number 10, which is a very tiny, you know, intimate, clubby venue, but you've played some big arenas as well, haven't you? That must be fairly heart-stopping.
It's exciting. I occasionally write with Ricky Ross, who runs Deacon Blue, and he said to me, I was playing with a three-piece band a couple of years ago, and he said to me, do you want to come and tour with us? And I leapt at the chance and said, yeah, definitely. And we did some lovely little kind of concert halls and so on, and then I was looking at the tour itinerary, and I said, what's this Liverpool Summer Pops Festival, Rick? And he said, oh, it's Liverpool Echo Arena, and we played 10,000 people at Liverpool Echo Arena, and it's an amazing experience, because the noise that 10,000 people make when you're the recipient of it, when you're on stage and everyone's making noise directly, it's physical, you can feel it, you can feel the sound that the audience are making, and yeah, it's amazing playing places like that. I also opened for 1142 about a year ago, and played the Royal Albert Hall and a few places like that. You know, again, it's great. My first thought when I walked on stage to soundcheck at the Royal Albert Hall was I looked around. I'd been to see Brian Wilson play there a few weeks before, and I walked out on stage and I looked around and I thought, it's not very big. And you had to sort of do a double take and go, come on, it's the Royal Albert Hall, don't be stupid. But it's...
just won't come. I've been looking for a job, but I ain't found one. Hold on, 'cause I'm making plans. And I promise you, I won't let you down.
working on now? Got some new things in the pipeline?
Yeah, I've got three projects on the go at the moment. I'm doing a blues album at the moment, which is going to come out on my own label, Den of Ecstasy, which is a project I put together. Actually, I started Den of Ecstasy about 4 years ago when I was working with an independent label called Folkwit. I started the label, but before I could get it established, I signed to Sony for an album in 2008. But after I left Sony, I went back to the label and I thought, you know, I'm going to develop this. And I sort of had distribution and radio and press and all of that. My last album, 9 Cents for Metalux, came out of my own label and was the best seller of my solo albums to date. So it's kind of, the label thing's gradually rolling, which is interesting. You know, it's a bit of a nightmare admin-wise, you know, too much time sitting in front of the computer rather than sitting in front of a microphone. But, so I'm doing a blues album for that label, and I've just done a licensing deal with a major label who are going to put out my next album, which is the next album after the blues one. Yeah. You know what I mean? And I'm also I've got my crazy producer hat on at the moment. I'm doing an album for a very exciting new act at the moment. Just being producer, playing some instruments, and you know, arranging things and you know, sitting twiddling knobs in the early hours of the morning of the electronic kind.
That's what I was going to say, yeah. Painted a picture there, rather than not have painted it this time of the morning.
Yes. It's exciting, you know. I'm getting all my sort of creative whims fulfilled, which is quite nice. I mean, I've been wanting to get into production I've been producing my own stuff for years.
Yeah.
And I've been wanting to get into production for quite a while, so, you know, it's nice to be able to sit back and shout at musicians.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, and you've got your own website, have you, where people can find you if they...
Jinder.co.uk is my website, which has got all sorts of information about my...
upcoming gigs and things.
Everything, and what I'm doing. So, yeah, that's probably the best place to check me out. And from there, you can find me on Twitter, YouTube, Bebo, Facebook, Tumblr, and all of that nonsense. Or just go for a walk in the sunshine and forget it all.
I can't help noticing there's a guitar next to you. I don't suppose you'd fancy giving us a little ditty, would you?
There is indeed. Yeah, I'll play this song. This song I wrote 4 a.m. in Kendal in the Lake District. Is Kendal in the Lake District?
I think it is.
Or is it in the Peak District?
I think Kendal Lake District.
Kendal in the Lake District. I wrote this song the early hours of the morning with a friend of mine, Lottie Mullen, who I was touring with at the time. And we both had a few drinks, and we were talking about how we should both give up drinking. And Lottie turned to me and said, "I've been giving up since I started." And straight away, out came a song. This is the song that we wrote. And it's called "Giving Up Since I Started." And this is going to be on my blues record, which is going to be out towards the end of the year. It goes something like this.
Since I started, I've been quitting since the day that I began. And I've been needing you since we parted. Ooh, and I've been wondering what it is that makes a man. But you know I can't put you down. I can't turn my life around. And no matter what I do, I keep on coming back to you. It's been a pretty good winning streak. For a loser, but every hand I play just doesn't feel like yours and mine.
break. 'Cause I won't remember. Ooh, ooh. And tonight I've been giving up. I'm giving up itself. But you know I can't put you down. Can't turn my life around. No matter what I do, I keep on coming back to you. And I've been giving up since I started. I've been needing you since we parted. I've been moving on. Since I got here, you know I've been happy in my own field. So pour me another drink, till I won't remember. Ooh, and tonight I've been giving up. I'm giving up. Well, tonight I've been giving up. I'm giving up. It's
thanks a lot, Jinder.
It's been a pleasure, and I shall talk to you again soon.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Cheers.
Are we finished now?
No, not yet.
Nice. No, I enjoyed that.